I'm all about campaigns, and I'm all about using Softr and its amazing URL parameters in order to set up great campaigns for things like influencer marketing and other initiatives. In this video, I'm going to dive into how you can take our URL parameters to capture the source of where people submitted forms from in something like an influencer marketing campaign. Let's jump right into it. As you can see, I've already set up a very basic form within Softr, and I'm going to show you exactly what the end result is and then work back. So to get started, you can see that I have two different influencers here. One is Greg and one's Andy. And Greg is going to, for example, if I click here, have a form where if I were to write out my name, like Jim Baker, and then jim@baker.com, and then submit the inquiry, you would see that in the submissions, it matches to Greg. Now, the way that this occurred was through this URL parameter in Softr. Let's show you how I did it. So first of all, what you're gonna need to do is create a new application, or say you're already in an application that has a form set up, go through and follow up and press create application. And then from there, you're gonna wanna make sure that your form page, like this one, is published and that the destination is going to a data source that you're gonna be working in for this. So I'm gonna go to my influencer marketing base in Airtable and select the submissions one. So you're gonna have a base in Airtable that is for both the influencers and the submissions. So in this case, what the source of the UTM parameters or URL parameters is, and then the actual submissions in here. And then I'm just gonna remove some of this other stuff and leave a few fields here. One is gonna be the full name, which is gonna match to the name. You can see in the submissions, I have a field for name, email, and then influencer. So in order to map to that influencer, I'm gonna add a field, and that is going to be a hidden field. We'll show you how this works in a moment. But I already have this page published, as well as the entire app. So in order for this to map together, what you essentially need to do is copy the subdomain, or the domain of your app, and create a formula field, or you do a concatenation of, do one of these short quotes, and you paste out the URL, and then you're gonna get the page URL as well. So you can go to settings of that form, go to general, and just copy /form, for example. Then you're going to put some sort of indicator of how this is sourced from a URL parameter standpoint. So I'm gonna put a question mark, and then I'm gonna put the, you can put influencer, you can put source. I'm gonna put influencer equals, and then you're gonna do this with a little comma, and then reference the name of that influencer. Then close the parentheses and press create field. Now, what this will do is this will essentially, when you're sharing this link out and somebody uses this as their URL parameter link, we then are going to make it so that the influencer field here catches the influencer during the submission by going back to Softr, get a refresh, get that field, and you're gonna take a look and say, okay, there's calculation here, but what is the name of the URL parameter? It should be influencer. Okay, let's go back here, go to hidden, then map to the influencer. And the value of that influencer, click URL parameter, then just type influencer. Could be source, could be whatever you end up putting after this question mark, and then between the equals here. Also make sure that everything is mapped within the rest of your fields. I know I put name, but let's also make sure email maps to email. And then we can press publish once again, go through one of the influencer links, and then type John Doe, and then john@doe.com. And after me submit, this should, in the submission area, capture the fact that it was Andy who was the influencer, because the form link had the URL indication that it was Andy. And we put here to map the value of what comes through from the URL parameter as influencer into our submissions. And this can be done in another layer. Say, for example, we were to have different campaigns for Greg and Andy. Go here, make a new field called campaign, and we could call this summer 2023. and do one of these by copying and pasting, and then make another formula for another example calculation. So we can do concatenate, and let's do actually our first calculation, and then follow it up with some quotes and do campaign equals, and then you're gonna pick another comma and do the campaign field. All right, once we create this field, this is another option, but I do want to make one caveat. We actually have to do and campaign equals so that we have now a UTM parameter that has the influencer, Vandy or Greg, and the campaign. So we can change it to different campaigns for different people, but it'd be the same thing that follows, right? So then what we would do in the submission area would put the single line text and put campaign, and then that's now refresh this field. And we would have the URL parameters map in that same way. So if we went here, we'd go hidden field, go to the campaign, and the value would be the URL parameter of, go here again, we look campaign equals, so that would mean it would be campaign. So then, say we were to publish this, and any item from Greg in this specific form now would be the Greg influencer and campaign. Let me do Jake Dosif. Let me do jakedosif.com. Submit. In our submissions, you'll see that it captures the influencer and the campaign. So this can be stretched out over multiple URL parameters so that we can see specifically where this came from. It is a little bit hard to start one of these, but once you get your head wrapped around the way that it works, and that is just fetching the URL side and mapping it to whatever the URL parameter equals, it's pretty easy to work with. Just like it's pretty easy to work with other videos like this one on how to improve your Softr skills even more.